Everybody, it's Evicta. 17 Union Streak here in the Binding of Isaac Victor Repentance series. Yesterday's video did not cross 5,000 likes yet. Well, as the absence of the like streak counter down below. But we do have an awesome meme of the day, artwork of the day, submitted by KookieElk1562. Although they did say in their title that credit goes to TLK_HH on Twitter. So I'm not sure if that's Kookie Elk or if they're just giving credit where credit's due. But either way, there's a really awesome engraving with the Sinvicta insignia logo on, I think that's wood or plastic. I'm pretty sure it's wood. So that would be awesome to like just see like hung up in like a glass frame, like a floating frame and stuff. Really good work indeed. So thank you very much, Kookie Elk and TLK_HH on Twitter. Go check them out if you'd like to. Let's hop on in. Let's see if Victory Laugh can give us a spicy one or not today. I don't know, man. I don't know. Victory Lab week's been pretty, I don't say easy, but tame so far. 37.3 November Whiskey Kilo Delta Hotel. We've got Torn Photo here along with the Blister. And Jar of Flies. Jar of Flies is pretty pogged. Anytime we kill an enemy, we're going to be able to get an attack fly that goes into the jar. And then whenever we get up to 20, or if we hit the spacebar item or use the item, is going to deploy and release all flies that we have currently. Now, this is going to be good because obviously we have no... we need to be very careful. We don't make any contact with Wrath. Wrath does count as a champion, so... at least I think he does. Yeah, having only one HP is definitely not super great. Anyway, we do have we've got a decent amount of damage here to start with. Our DPS is great because of Torn Photo, though, is what I meant to get at. We'll take Pay to Win. Pay to Win is going to give us a reroll machine inside of our item rooms, and I guess we'll just go ahead and take this as well. Not in this item room, of course. We have to be in one that isn't open in order for it to activate. Yeah, brother, a random brother Bobby just sitting out here, just doing whatever. Yeah, you knew that one was coming. So we definitely don't want to go down to a half heart here. Yeah, so far anyway, the runs that we've been getting from Victory Lap Week have not really been too punishing. We had maybe like one or two. Definitely that first or second run that we did was kind of spicy. But we were able to fight through it finally. And then, of course, the only other one that was somewhat challenging was the one where the power went out. And the run that I had before the power went out was super... It was challenging, but only because the D8 was just giving us horrible rolls. And, you know, I'm still bummed that we lost that footage. But, I mean, that's basically old news at this point. Isn't it funny how quickly, like, stuff becomes old news on YouTube? Dude, that was like a day ago. What are you talking about? We're over it. God. And then, like, if you start, like, talking about it again, people are like, oh, my gosh, stop dwelling on it. It's like, okay, well, you know, maybe people haven't seen that one yet, you know? You never know. I don't know. Half of this art form is just repetition over and over and over and over and over again. All repetition. That happens when you're a solo commentator. Tiki Room is going to be there. Are we going to stick with Boom, or are we going to stick? Are we going to go to Jar of Flies? I don't know. Also, I don't know where our Secret Room is. It's not. Okay, yeah, it has to be here. No, it can't be there. What am I talking about? The Super Secret Room is there. It's got to be here. We know that it's not above. Maybe it's above the Cursed Room. That's a very odd spot for it, though. We're gonna find the secret room. Okay, it is there. Was that worth all the bombs? No, of course not. I made up for it a little bit anyway. I don't know if we're gonna stick with Jar of Flies over Mr. Boom. Mr. Boom's got a lot of practical application, especially for offense. I wouldn't mind getting the blue map just so we can avoid having to do what we just did, which is like wasting a bunch of bombs looking for the secret rooms. I was really hoping there's gonna be a full charge in here. It was a little bit premature of me to, all right, fine. Fine, I'll take Brother Bobby now, I guess. See, it's hard to get really excited about seeing Famine nowadays in Repentance. But we get a cube meet, and we know we're going to have reroll machines on the in the next. We know we're going to get a reroll machine in the next item room and beyond because we have pay to win. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually use one more bomb just to get a little bit of money. By a little bit, I mean the literal bare minimum of money. And that way we have at least something we can roll with in case if we do get something, an item in the item room that we don't want. We'll head on down. And Curse of the Lost.
Nice blue map, nerd.
Let's stick with Mr. Boom over the Jar of Flies, obviously. I think that for early boss killers, it's just safer and better. But Jar of Flies is very good. It's just, I think that the better offensive play would just be, instead of us dealing like a decent amount of damage over the course of like 20 times, why not just do a massive amount of damage one time? just mop them up. Sometimes even like one shot, like one hit KO amounts of damage. Pretty many right now. And this was the dead end too. All right. Alrighty. Already starting game, huh? The free two bombs here. And we get two more bombs there, all right. Okay, so it's gonna be so far so linear. Thank you, Brother Bobby, appreciate that. Half Soul Heart came a room too late. I think that if you kill one of those mosquitoes and they take a charge from you, I think that you should be able to get that charge back when you kill them. Or would that be too fair? Is that too fair for repentance? Yeah, too fair. Repentance doesn't want to do that? Okay. It was just a suggestion. Sure. Why not? Why not? We haven't had Epic Fetus in a little while, even though I don't like the item. It's something different. Suplex. I mean, we could use suplex, I suppose, but it's a good way to lose, like, basically all of our... all of our soul hearts that, and devil deals in case we thought we were going to get any. But Epic Fetus is going to give us a Predator Missile tier, as you see here, which is basically going to destroy everything and do lots and lots of damage, although you do have to be careful because you can deal damage to yourself, and that's the biggest risk factor when you're talking about Epic Fetus. Of course, now the bigger, bolder plan of all this is the fact that, like, you know, you can get... It's unlimited bombs. I mean, it is quite literally unlimited bombs. But thanks to repentance, you can also reroll. So if you don't want repentance if you don't want Epic Fetus in repentance anymore, unlike Afterbirth and Afterbirth Plus, you wouldn't be able to reroll Epic Fetus no matter what. You actually can reroll Epic Fetus in repentance, so that's a good change. Just trying to get to 15 cents here, maybe a little bit more. Donation machine guy, I'm sorry. But we've been putting a lot back into our donation machine, so I'm perfectly fine with taking a little bit of a withdrawal here. Call that skimming the profits in this industry. Called investing, sweetheart, look it up. I have an 81% chance for Deal with the Devil now. Explosion after explosion. We do get our double deal. And we get Mom's Knife and Twisted Pear. How's that going to work with Epic Fetus, I wonder? Oh, Lord. All right, well, we wanted spice. We got spice. All right, so the goal is to not kill ourselves. If we can get into this bedroom here, then all danger is gone. Because we can get a bedroom or a bed out of this. The twisted pear shot not moving the same speed as my shot is horrifying, though. By speed, I mean like the reticule speed. Okay, so danger, the danger is so, danger right now is, for all intents and purposes, gone of us one-shotting ourselves or, like, us hurting ourselves via twisted pear. A horse pill over here. But you know we gotta take it. Good luck. The Ankh wouldn't be too bad, but we're looking for something more. We'll take Brittle Bones. Brittle Bones would give us a nice Tears Up. Not that Tears Ups really matter with Epic Fetus. So we get a Tears Up every time that we lose one of these Bone Hearts that we have been granted. And there's a child's drawing, which we don't really need because obviously Guppy and Epic Fetus don't really go hand together too much. But we're just doing buku amounts of damage. We could re-roll this. I will risk re-rolling this. The only reason why you saw me do what I just did right there is because I wanted to get the tears up from Brittle Bones. Yeah, the Cantor Trinket we can I don't know. Do we want the Cantor Trinket? Gonna take the key because we need keys. Oh, what just happened? So our damage kind of took a hit. Oh, that rerolled. Okay, apparently that reroll paid a win as well. I'm not sure why, but. Unless the six room does everything now, like all the rooms. We are going to get Keeper Sack, which is a fantastic item for us. We're just getting damage left and right here, which is exactly what we need. So we got the ladder, raw liver, dead bird, the backpack or school bag, 2020, scary face, and nightlight. Not sure why we're able to see where the secret rooms are, unless Blue Map was still hooking us up, despite us losing it now. Let's go see if we can build something greater out of this. 3.29 damage is not great damage. Are we going to possibly lose this run? Well, right now we're looking good, but again, our damage or lack thereof is a little bit worrying. I get a double deal here. And hold on to the Cancer Trinket just because it does break the tears cap. We could and should go into our cursed room. Since we have so much HP. Two spooky faces, just horrific. You know what? You know what? Pay to play probably got shuffled. It probably didn't re-roll. It got shuffled by Curse the Maze. That's probably what happened. Well, maybe not. Looking on the map for a white star, and I don't see one other than the one that's inside of the cursed room. If we've already been in there, we know that that's the red patch. Yeah, maybe it just got re-rolled. Who knows? Who knows? All right, we got a stars card here. My least favorite rooms. But we're going to put up with it, though, because I want to go into the curse room. I'm going to go in the curse room here just to see what is good. What's good, curse room? How you been? Stars. Iron bar, which is going to give us a little bit of a damage up in the concussive shots as well, but nothing to really write home about. Our money is decent, though. Yeah, this would cost two to a room that Sinvicta just doesn't feel like doing. I didn't use a bomb there, but I'm going to anyway. The ladder is allowing us to walk over these gaps, by the way, which is very nice. I don't want to call it pseudo-flying, because it has nothing really to do with flying other than you getting to places that are over cracks. Our plug is basically useless for us here. Until we find something better than the poop. Actually surprised there's no needles in here. Oh, okay. I don't know what... Not sure what my eyes are thinking or seeing right now, but, like, you need to... Like, we're not getting that close to the spikes. I guess we're not supposed to be. You get another devil deal here. Thank you, Matchbook. Appreciate it. Oh boy, Sister Maggie. Mm-hmm. Completing the family here, I see. How about that? Got the whole family here. Well, not yet, but I mean, this is working on it. Yeah, so with 360 damage, I mean, like, as you can see, like, even with 2020, like, we're still crushing a lot of these. I don't want to say crushing. We're beating a lot of these rooms before they can really, like, take off. And that's a good place to be. But for bosses, that's a different story. Without us having Mr. Boom now, you know, we don't have a lot of like burst damage now. You know, re-rolling epic fees. So, oh, I just realized that we also have PhD, bad PhD that is. So that's interesting. So I need to be looking out for pills here, although I would hate to lose tiers for damage. Yeah, bad PhD, the raw liver, nightlight. We could also just ignore bad PhD and go for damage upgrades based off of having keeper sack. You got 0.89 damage there. Think we got damage? Speed down, damage up. Puberty. Health down, damage up. Then we can spend 7 more cents and get another upgrade. So just like that, bad PhD and keeper sack just took us from not so great to we're doing, I mean, we just got done talking about how we had 3.6 damage and now we're rocking 6.10 damage. So, you know, we didn't necessarily just double all of our damage, but we got close. I mean, even get dead cat here. I think this is going to be a nice try. Yo, spikes, what's going on here? We can dodge. We have it in our capacity to dodge spikes, brain. Why are we not dodging spikes? Blood puppy, sure, come on down, blood puppy. Even though blood puppy is a bad item, that's right, I said it. Nightlight kind of shielded that chest and made it look like it wasn't a haunted chest. Even though blood puppy is a bad item, we'll still take you, blood puppy. I don't know if we're going to be able to let Blood Puppy get to level 3, but we can try. Definitely don't need bombs anymore, so I'm going to take the callus, as the aforementioned spikes have been we've been hit by 3 spikes now, and that's 3 HP that I definitely want back. Oh, 2 bad trip pills, huh? Which unfortunately false PhD doesn't do anything about that. Don't be falling, so we get a chance here to get a to get another Devil Deal item. Or not, that's fine too. Central Spirit, we're not gonna go into the second, we don't need to go alt path yet. Maybe on the victory lap. The Curse of the Lost here. I think using one bomb to get one key is good. I probably could have placed it there and gotten the other scent up there, but I didn't. I didn't. Sorry. Not sorry. Eventual Spirit, which is going to give us a familiar that fires, I think, every time we take damage. My God. My God. Oh my God. That was an actual by God. And then I didn't expect Pin to jump there. It startled me. I thought Pin was going to be up in the upper left. Looking for the shop here so we can get more and more damage via keeper sack. Yeah, I guess we can go in. I mean, there's not really a reason to not go in the bedroom. But we can't get a our three soul hearts, and there's also a Larry Jr. in here. That should be a clean getaway here. And yep. Now, the reason why we can't get three soul hearts on that bed is not because it's a clean room or anything like that. It's because we actually have a red heart that prevents us from having all soul hearts. You can only get three soul hearts on a bed payout if you have nothing but soul hearts. Or if you have no... You basically have to have no red hearts, period. Including bone hearts. Target damage is hopefully right around 10 or so. If we can get that, that'd be nice. Don't have to worry about Blood Puppy anymore. We'll be able to put him down pretty easily. There we go. That's what you want to do in here. Whenever you have a nightlight like this, what you want to do is you want to try to bum rush whatever the first and closest target that you see. Because you have the nightlight, it's going to really, really freeze them up and probably stop them from taking any action. This is how you do this room. Don't try to sneak up and down with the spike. Go left or right. A puppy. So we'll go fight Mom. We use the fool card to get out. Unfortunately, we did miss boss rush, but that's to be expected. A puppy. Okay, Blood Puppy, you gotta calm down. Yeah. Yeah, this is not a good devil deal. So we're gonna go back to the fool card, or use the fool card, I should say, and hopefully go find the store. We want the store because, again, we want to use Keeper Sack and utilize those damage ups that we can get from it. It's not the store at all. Okay. Professional booth is kind of meh. If we had any broken hearts, we definitely would use the confessional, but we didn't take empty hearts, so it doesn't really matter. Still just kind of looking for our item room and our shopperino. We'll take growth hormones. The good use of the fool card there. Because it's not a fight that I really, it's not a room I really feel like doing. Growth Hormone is going to give us a movement speed upgrade and a damage upgrade, which is kind of nice. There's just one big... Oh, no, it wasn't. I thought this was a dead end. Could be mistaken on that. It was a dead end because that's where the bedroom is. All right. There's our boss trap room. This is not too... We've already been there. Where have we not been yet? That's what I want to know. Because that's where we need to go. Yeah, we've not been down here. I know that. Apparently the tears from Central Spirit are their spectral tears. I guess that makes sense if they're from Ventral Spirit. The being, you know, ethereal and all. We are going to get Jacob's Ladder, which is a great opportunity for us to really start balling out of control here. Would love to get more shot speed for sure. But Jacob's Ladder is a huge, huge spike to our power curve. Right. That was definitely worth it. Glad we went all that way for us to use Keeper's Sack. Mm-hmm. All right. Well, Jacob's Ladder is still a pretty big win. Again, Jacob's Ladder is just going to just absolutely wreck everything. Where did our blue fires go? I think they got shuffled into another room hallway. Anyway. Head on down. I was very touched by how many people showed interest in my poor sapling's health. A lot of people were curious as far as, like, you know, what kind of stories did I read it to make sure it wasn't scared and all that kind of stuff. And I was like, eh. I read it a good story. I made him some cookies so he wouldn't be so scared outside. You know, he's got friends. He's got more trees back there. He's got more. Didn't have squirrels, but he's got birds that goes out there and hangs out with him. Maybe all right. That really did legit worry me though, like to the point where I would not have been able to fall asleep had I not gone and resecured the steak. We could play a judgment in here, and if it gives us a regular judgment, that could be pretty pogged. Because judgment will pay out with whatever. I think. Actually, I could be wrong about that. Yeah. Okay. Never mind. I'm gonna say halfway through that, I remember someone telling me because that was my plan the last time, and someone in the comments said no, the judgments don't pay out with their loot tables anymore based on the room that they're in. It just goes to the global. Loot table. So yeah, that pretty much doesn't confirm it, but that pretty much affirms it. Oh, thank you, Blood Puppy. Yeah, see, this is why Blood Puppy's gotta go. Sorry, Blood Puppy. I'd love to get you to level 3 because it is funny to see you like just trounce around and, you know, just do lots of damage and stuff, but like you also deal a lot of damage to me and I can't have that. There's the western side of the map. We are looking more towards the... There we go. I'm going to get some kind of piercing shots. It would be nice. Piercing shots are always going to be nice. Good damage there. Great, great damage there with Anarchist Cookbook. Totally hard countered Blast Assist. We get blue cap, which is going to give us an HP upgrade and a tears up again. But man, if we could just get a little bit of damage, a little bit more damage, I'll be happy.
Did Victor happy? No.
There you go. Charming effect actually working for once. Secret room might be there. It sometimes can be. Sometimes not. kind of afraid of that. But we did gain more damage. We don't really have a whole lot of movement speed to be giving, though. But the damage that we have now is getting better and better and better. Such a satisfying pop. I gotta say, the ladder's been helping us out, get some pretty clutch items. I mean, we haven't been needing bombs for a while, but like, you know, I'm satisfied with the amount of consumables that we've been getting just kind of second-handedly from us having the, and it's not second-handedly, it's directly because of the ladder. It's nice having to not have to worry about going over the gaps and stuff. And for just general mobility as well, because the mobs, unless they're flying, they can't really do that. The super secret room is going to give us a whole lot of charges. And also a whole lot of nothing in here. All right. All right. Neat. So is this the right way to go? Nope. That's just one big old Isaac circle. I got something stuck in my eye. Eyelashes are... There we go. I'll take my glasses off because, now we're talking about spice. Now we're talking spice here. Magic skin. So magic skin opens up another world of possibilities here. If we find the item room, the secret room. So now what we're looking for is our secret room, because we want to get all those fantastic, whimsical, wonderful secret room items like rock bottom. Our key wouldn't be too bad either. And we have all those soul hearts as well. Of course, we would have a golden troll bomb in here, so... I'm going to use magic skin. And transcendence is pretty good. We'll get flying. Now, really, ideally, you want to be using magic skin in a reroll situation. Ideally. So this is really not an ideal situation for using magic skin, but we're going to roll with it anyway. Just because we're about to go into Shoal for the first time, and I think that would be good for us to have a... If we can get rock bottom here, that's the dream, is getting rock bottom. Rock bottom and arc key wouldn't be bad either. Yeah, so that's contract from below, which... Or not contract from below, that's missing page number 2. Every time we use magic skin, we're going to gain an empty heart. We do have to be... There's a limit to how many empty hearts you can take, really. Got all those charges in the super secret room as well. So sausage is a fantastic all stats up. And we've gotten flying and sausage so far just from magic skin. Not going there yet. I'm willing to use it one more time here for now. Dad's ring. Ugh. Dad's ring is kind of... I mean, we could get one more full charge. If we go all the way back, grab the mini charges, and then clear the rest of this. Dad's ring is going to give us a little bit of extra crowd control protection here. Gonna clear these rooms or not? We just need one more. Hermit card, very nice. Use that for random teleportation in the dark chest. There we go. All right, Blood Puppy. I'm holding you directly responsible for this reroll, or for this roll. Sack of sacks. So we're out of soul. We're out of red hearts now. We're just operating exclusively on soul hearts. And we need to start thinking about how much damage, or how much, yeah, I mean, really, how much damage we're going to do to our HP. Not sure what's hitting me over there. Okay. This is what I would call a substandard double deal. We're going to head on to Zaun. I hope everyone's week has been going well. Again, I appreciate everyone checking on in with me in the mosh pit, letting us know if you've been affected by the hurricane. We got another, even as we speak now, we got another storm brewing down in the Gulf, unfortunately. So hopefully it misses us, but this one's looking like it's going to be geared straight towards our way. And you know, that's just unfortunate, but I always enjoy hearing updates from people. There's a lot of people been around here for a while that we care about. Spider-Mod guy would be one of them. Yeah, I mean, we care about everyone, obviously, but there's some more prolific members of the Mosh Pit who go either way. I mean, Spider-Mod guy became his own thing because of just how long his, not only how long his streak was going, but also because of just the length of the write-ups that he would do. You know, very wholesome, very fantastic write-ups. And you know, Spider-Mod guy, he turned out to be you know, an important part in the Mosh Pit comment section. Not to say that no one else is important, of course. We have Chocolate Milk guy. We got Laura. We got a lot of people who again just go above and beyond to leave their comment streaks in the comments and support the channel on the algorithm and whatnot. The goal is to beat the algorithm. That's what you want. That's what you want. Is having your viewers and your audience to beat the algorithm. Because the algorithm really is the gangly, misshapen beast that controls everything on YouTube. And you know, you gotta bow to its wishes, basically. But anytime you can get a little bit back, you should seize it. Which is why I like keeping people informed on how, like, the best way to support the channel, yada yada yada. And I know that the comment section on our videos do turn some people off, not everybody, but it turns some people off because they're like, what is this? Like, why is every comment just day of? But what that should really do is that should tell you how dedicated and loyal and supportive everyone who watches these videos are. Because you really don't see that. I mean, that trend, to my knowledge, that the trend of putting day of and then blah, 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 just to support a creator started in the Mosh Pit. And then you go to other people's channels, you just see it all over the place. It's like, yeah, we started that. And the reason why people do it is to, A, they have to do it in that format because you can't just post like the same comment over and over and over again and expect the algorithm to treat that as engagement. That's not how it works. And people do change up their streaks, they change up their wording and that sort of thing, all in the interest of making them unique comments that help boost the channel and the algorithm. Isaac's tomb is kind of meh. I'll take it. All right, we gotta hunker down here, Blood Puppy. Stanley means business. See if we can do this on 1 HP here. I didn't even see that brimstone. Not sure why Stanley's firing brimstone that way. I also don't know how we got hit by that. we go. That's a much cleaner bomb. My puppy. Yeah, see, that's where, this is where concussive tears really kind of like throw you off. Because it makes them kind of jostle and like sway like that, and it makes their movements very unpredictable, and also makes hitting them very unpredictable. I'm gonna try to do as much damage as possible to Stanley here. That's really the only dangerous phase, is phase one of Satan. Like I say, the rest are easy, of course, but a lot easier than the statue phase. Unless, of course, they just spawn like a bomb fly right on you, then that's fine too, I guess. Sure, game. Gotta love it. I really, really hate how you can't see Isaac behind the legs of Satan that take up the entire screen. All right, enough of this messing around here. We're done with this. We're done dizzle with this. So here's what's gonna happen. We're gonna get a good devil item here. Devil deal here. I'm gonna save that last soul heart. Yeah, so we can take all these. It's gonna take all of our lives, but we can take all of these. We get Incubus, we get Death Touch. Or no, we can't get those. I really want Death Touch. Am I willing to take it over Brimstone though? I'm gonna say yes. You can also take Lemme Get Down. We got Jawbone. Okay. Our goal will be to hopefully get Brimstone. Hopefully. But Death's Touch with this tears rate and Incubus is pretty big. It's a lot of damage. Brimstone, I'm still going to try to get, but I actually don't know if Brimstone is the right play here. Because Brimstone, we lose Jacob's Ladder if we take Brimstone. So maybe Brimstone isn't the right play. We should just hold on to this extra life here and any HP that we get. Shot speed down. We've already lost a lot of shot speed. Okay, well, Hermit Card didn't get us anywhere. All right, so I mean, all we gotta do is just get through the Dark Chest without taking damage and beat Lamb without taking damage. How hard is that? Give me a challenge, game. That's funny. Glitter bombs. Oh man, Jawbone completely canceled out that shot. That was great, Jawbone. Can't cancel out that shot though. Power card, death card, ancient recall. You get ace of diamonds, the hangman, and the hierophant. Reverse. Which is going to give us two bone hearts. And that's actually even better than getting soul hearts at this point. So we can take brimstone now if we really wanted to, but I honestly do think that taking brimstone here is a mistake. I think it's not the correct play. For the ninth time now. Like I said, this commentary is—it's all about repetition, man. You're a solo commentator. This is all you can really do. I don't like that pattern at all. Let's not ever do that ever again. Samson's Chainy. Don't know about this one. Hangman, no thank you. We'll take this just for the ads or something. If we run into something we don't care, we don't want to really fight. We just use it now and get nothing for it. That's fine too. Woo! All right, we made it. I do kind of hate that King Baby is preventing Incubus from dealing damage here. So the end of this run got a little spicy for lap number one. We kind of made it spicy on ourselves here just because we have magic skin. We still have magic skin. There we go. Good damage there. Absolutely. All right, second seed, Bravo Hotel X-Ray 1, Sierra Whiskey, Bravo Papa. Apple Sodom. I mean, we really don't need the... We don't need the callus anymore, but we'll take a little battery, though. We're catching back up here in our HP. I'm hoping that we can find a... Confessional booth. Hey. Oh. All right, let's get rid of Sat. Let's get rid of... we have to pick up magic skin just so we stop seeing it. But we got ourselves an R key now. And now what do we do? Now remember, we still have Keeper's Sack, so we're still going to be gaining gaining stats, as it's commonly referred to as stuff. So I don't think we need to use the magic skin anymore until we find a confessional booth. I don't think this tears up is going to do anything for us. Oh, it did do something for us. Wow. Wow. Polydactyl allows us to carry two consumables. I really don't want to be the hangman. Thank you very much. Now the question becomes, when do we use our R key? And not for a while is the answer. Now when we use our R key, what we can do is we can go for angel deals instead. And we can, from there... We can hopefully spawn a confessional to get rid of these empty hearts. That's the only way to get rid of the empty hearts. A puppy. Love if he just like immediately transformed to level 3 there because he was on top of Envy. I think so. Absolutely need Ares. We need movement speed. We're looking pretty darn good. I will admit that it's hard to kind of see Isaac when he's red like this from Too Spooky and differentiate him and Blood Puppy. Making it a little bit tricky. So I'm going to, of course, go back and we're going to try to find the store just so, again, we can capitalize on having Keeper Sack. And wouldn't you know it, the only place we haven't been at is where the store is at. There's our tienda. And we get a half-price birthright, sure. And that gives us Venus or Double Whore of Babylon. I mean, I guess we take Venus. The Fortune. So as you see here, we're already filled up on HP. But we're done. We're done with magic skin for now. The dead gave us bookworm. Head on down. I think what we do is we try to go for Delirium on this run. Although, well, that's going to be hard to do because we don't have Golden Key. So we can't really do Mega Stand. Although, but that being said though, it doesn't really matter because like we're still going to have to do Delirium either way. Take Guppy's Tail. His tail gives us a good amount of extra chest spawns, and we have enough keys to be sufficient. Yeah, we can take Endless Nameless. Gives us a 25% chance to not consume a usable item whenever we do use them, which is not very often. But when it pays out, it pays out. Seeing the frequency of these chests are spawning at now, thanks to Guppy's Tail. When you have enough keys to open them up, it's brilliant. It's great. When you don't, it sucks. And I think the mother transformation icon up here looks like Danny from Game Grumps. Tell me you don't see that. Tell me that mom transformation doesn't look like Danny. I think doing something with Aaron and Dan would be the next collab goal. Doing something with those two would be fun. Yeah, it definitely would be probably possible. I think that would be really neat. Abba-dabba ding dong. I think a Abaddon would actually not be a good idea here. We need these bone hearts, and we could take perfection, but I think we're probably gonna lose it. I have a lot of friends who've worked with the Game Grumps over the years. Jesse and, oh man. So does the golden filigree feather, does that give us two items from an Angel Deal statue now? We could also go for the sacrifice rooms, but that would require an extensive amount of red heart HP on the ground. Recover. For our not for the angel items, but just for the key pieces. And namely Jesse and Michelle. Both of them have been doing stuff with Game Grumps before. I don't know if Coach Krendor ever did or not. I don't think he did. Mother Transformation. Someone will have to fact check that for me. So we didn't find our we have not found our item room yet. Not that we didn't find it, we just haven't. That'd be cool. What game out of all games that exist? If let's hypothetically say this is me polling the mosh pit right now. What game that hypothetically exists would you want to see me play with the Game Grumps on? I have a couple games in mind that I would love to play with Aaron and Dan, but I don't want to influence the pool in any way, shape, or form. So I'm not going to say which ones. I'll let this video simmer for a couple days, and then if I remember to answer it, I'll remember it. I'll give my answer. Gonna totally forget. So we needed a little bit more red heart HP here before we can really make the sacrifice room pop. Or risk losing all of our bone hearts, which as you can see, bone hearts are the only thing keeping us alive right now. We have plenty of bombs, so this is no big deal. Who would even be excited to see something like that? To see a Game Grumps mosh pit collab. Do we lose our bone heart if we tap that again on an empty bone heart? Or does it go to our next bone heart? I think it goes. I want to say it probably goes on this bone heart. I'll test it after we get this payout. Let's not go down the hole. Hey, we got the soul heart. Okay, yeah, it does take away from your bone hearts. That's what I thought. That's what I thought. The golden filigree feather just screw us there. I'm not sure why was there a delay? Why was there a delay on Gabriel spawning? That's the only reason why I even tapped that again. That's annoying. Well, I guess we're gonna have to use our R key now. We could do another victory lap and then go through the motions again. But we're going to lose a lot of our items. That was not my intention there. I thought that, okay, maybe we need to tap it one more time. But the delay on Gabriel's spawning was what caused me. I was like, oh, we must not have hit it enough times. Yeah, we'll just use the R key now. We don't have to do an Omega run. So the seed is going to stay the same. Bravo Hotel X-Ray 1, Sierra Whiskey, Bravo Papa. We just reset the run now. We just get a totally different run. Ludovico Technique. We get Death List here. Okay, so now we can get Angel Deals. And I think we can still get another R key if I really, really, really wanted to do another victory lap, like an Omega run, but this video is already an hour and 6 minutes long. We didn't really do much. Well, that's not true. Okay, we've done a lot, but I'm just, you know what I mean. In terms of like the Omega run, like we haven't done, I was originally going to go to Boss Rush there, and we were going to go get Mega Stand and all that kind of good stuff, but now it's kind of like I don't know if that's tenable now. And the only reason why I say that too is just because of the simple fact that we have all these broken hearts. If we can get rid of these empty hearts here, I would try for an Omega run. But now we need to get a second R key, which is probably not going to happen. So we can go for Angel Deals here on this run. Wonder if this will re-roll. I wonder if M will re-roll into R key. That would mean that we'd have to use magic skin again first. I mean, if we wanted a really fast moving space bar item, there we go. Okay, so it only rerolls the active space bar item. It doesn't reroll magic skin. Unless we use it. That's good to know. Huh. M's actually pretty interesting here. So we take super bandages for the red heart upgrade, and obviously we can't go past what we already have. And I'm not going to go for double deal. We're going to go for angel deals this time. So we have friend finder. Happy that we have one more life here. Here we get the pony. Hey, everybody. Also, just occurred to me that we lost the cancer item. Drink it anyway. That's death certificate, so we can get our R key back. Yo. Let's just go get it. Okay, so M, I may need to reevaluate where I placed M on the trinkets tier list, because that's actually not bad at all. It never really occurred to me that you could do that. You could reroll into something like death certificate or R key. Act of contrition. Of course, you have to be. It's always so tense in here, because as soon as you tap an item, it's gone. Everything else is gone. There's rock bottom. We're not interested in rock bottom, though. All right, Blood Puppy, we need you to sniff out the R key. There it is. Genesis wouldn't be bad either, but I think that R key is better, because if we're trying to do this, R key is better. Okay, I'm going to take member card here. Kind of hoping that they were going to revert back to money just for the membership card. I don't know why I thought that, but... EP's number one is a go. Wafer is going to be huge for us. So we don't really need M anymore, but I'm going to hold on to it anyway. We can take perfection, I suppose. Make sure we switch off our key. We don't want to accidentally reroll. Or we don't want to accidentally use it, I should say. Okay, so the things that we need to accomplish on this lap are Boss Rush, Hush, Blue Baby, Isaac, Mom's Heart, Mega Satan, and then Delirium. Then we R key, go for Mother, and then have to hope we get another R key, which may be possible with M still. Airwalk is going to be really useful for Delirium. The reason why we have to do Delirium now is just because we're going to have to fight Mega Satan anyway, and Mega Stanley can shut us down from getting to Delirium. Or we use R key. We use R key as Mega Stand is dying, like we did in the Omega run. But I'm willing to just roll with it. Let's see if we can make it happen. Now, us rolling into Diplopia is also a possibility. With M. So the chance of us getting another Arky is not out of the question. We would just have to use magic skin at least once. Oh, we got a half tiers up as well. The problem that sort of puts us on is that then we risk running too low of HP. Is that gonna give us the deal with the devil precedent if we take that? Also, I don't know why our deal with the devil precedent is. Oh, it's because we missed the angel deal. Never mind. Deal with the angel precedent is what I meant to say. We missed the angel deal on the last floor. That's right. Yeah, we missed boss rush, but we can get boss rush on the way back. There's our angel deal. Ashes is rags. It does give us another HP. It does give us another life. Yeah, there's our key piece. Got pushed into the fire through the pedestal. Blue cap. That's going to lower our damage a little bit. I'm not sure why that happened. Then we can take the halo down here, which will convert some of our red hearts. Some of our soul hearts to red hearts, basically. Could take divorce papers. But I think we have enough tears. Haven't been in our item room. Okay, so now that we have the red heart, we can use magic skin and re-roll it. I'm hoping that we just find a space bar item that I can just use without having to use magic skin, because I really don't want to lose another heart container. Pretty awful. Make sure I'm not going crazy. I'm going to double back and just double check the shop one more time. There's not a space bar item here that I could have had. Yeah, this PhD. I mean, PhD wouldn't be bad, but like we have enough stats to win at this point. Now we're just kind of like theorizing, like what's the best strategy to go through to make this happen. Isaac's tomb giving us this extra item pedestal here. So the plan is for us to find a useless space bar item that we can instantly reroll instead of magic skin, because again, I don't want to lose our red heart container. And then we try to roll into Diplopia. And then we'll need another item pedestal to put Arky down and then use Diplopia. Or we roll into another Arky, which I don't know if it's possible or not. Yeah, there's Mr. Me. That is not a useless space for item. And placebo as well. I think we'd go with Mr. Me. We're gonna re-roll Mr. Me. Wouldn't mind stopwatch. Get the tear detonator. Of course, we would get the D100, wouldn't we? Wouldn't we, game? We have placebo now. There's the trinket smelter. This is a very, very drawn out way of doing this. I'm not sure if this is the only way we could have done this, but this is a way that makes sense to me. Now we're almost certainly going to see magic skin again because we're not holding it anymore. And do I really want to? I'm not sure if I want to smelt M. I will smelt the rotten penny, though. It stayed as the smelter. So does that mean that we're out of space bar items that we can possibly roll through, or is that just a quinky dink? Oh, I'm an idiot. The reason why it didn't work, Vic does, because you dropped M. There's no way to use the space bar item and roll it with M if you don't have M. That's why. Look, it's late. I'm tired. Okay, that's all right. We're going to stick with this plan. Okay, so we need to get the Polaroid. And we need to go. Oh, we need to get moving. We gotta fight old Hushy. Yep. Gotta go fight old Hushy. Got damage up, very nice. Wavy cap, I'm sorry. Apologize, viewers. So it's no big deal, I don't think, anyway, if we re-roll. Ah, but we have no way of dropping our key, though. I don't know how this is going to work, but we're going to find out. Okay, Giga Bean. Thank you very much for that, Monstrance. Appreciate it. We lost, because it was a one-time use item, we lost our space bar item. But we can get magic skin back, though. Bogatory. Yeah, we got 2 minutes to get to Old Hushy. Okay, so we can get into the Hush fight no matter what now. I do wish that confessional boosts were a little bit more prevalent. Didn't think it was there, but I figured I'd try. Now here's a run that we would want Shielded Tears with. I think we use magic skin in here one more time. Okay, we get I Agreed and Butterbean. We're probably going to end up getting magic skin again, let's just be honest. Get Dark Arts. I wonder if we can get Damocles out of this. Yeah, so we're maximum 3 HP now. This is starting to get risky. Round nugget. One minute. Wait, what? Wooden nickel. Let's go fight old Hushy. Obviously, this is super risky because we don't have Polar Invincibility right now. So there is, we can take Minecrafter, but it's gonna blow us up again as soon as we touch it. Okay, Box of Spiders won't though. Yeah, there's Yuck Heart. Another Keeper's Sack, which would give us, do we get Polar Invincibility off of Empty Hearts now? Now I'm starting to second guess that. A Dice Shard wouldn't be horrible. Probably should have actually used that shard in here with all the stuff on the ground, but oh well. I want to go get our... I'm going to go with the Magician, the Reverse Magician card and the Arrowwalk card with hopes that we don't have to use either one on Hush, but I will if I have to. Seeing projectiles is going to be very difficult. We pretty much have to beast mode this. I think we got Sack Dagger from Cambion Conception, maybe? Not sure where we got Sack Dagger from. One of the spacebar items. Here comes the Continuum phase. If we're lucky, we can dodge it. By dodge, I mean like completely bypass it. I think we're doing enough damage. Okay. Good. No hit, Hush. Get metronome. Oh no. Now, as powerful as we are on this run, we don't have a lot of HP. Delirium is not a surefire thing. So assuming that that Megastand sends us to Delirium, we still have to contend with the very real possibility of dying on Delirium. Just because, you know, he's such a great fight. It's very well designed and not broken at all. Oh my god. X-lax. I think Matthias had a little bit too much fun with that one. The Berserk. Now, Berserk might actually be something that we want to hold on to till Delirium, because we can't die as long as Berserk is active. And if we can somehow get him down before dying, remember, we still have one life and we have Lazarus's rags. So I may hold off on using Berserk. Just waiting and seeing if we can get to Delirium. If we do, then, you know, using that. We're going to have to use Arrowwalk and Magician on Delirium. I mean, that's the whole plan there. Because Delirium is the real problem. Mega Satan and Blue Baby are not going to be an issue. It's Delirium that's the big turd in the punch bowl. We can get Crack the Sky and then re-roll it. Telekinesis ain't bad either. And then we're going to come back and get Berserk. Mush. So what we're doing right now is we're going to go fight Blue Baby just to get him out of the way. And then we're going to go fight Megastan. Oh, man. Restock Machine could be pretty nice. Birdcage, fat buddy. Now here's something that's interesting as well, is that if we get a portal, if we get a Delirium portal from Blue Baby, we can use Teleport 2.0 to get out of the Mega Satan room and cancel the death animation before Mega Satan has a chance to not give us a Delirium portal. Top speed upgrade. Tech one with this tears rate is pretty good, but I think the Death's Touch is still better. Not Death's Touch, but I think that Jacob's Ladder is still better. Although with the range, no, we have plenty of range. Our range is 24. We should be able to hit Delirium from across the screen. Yeah, with this shot speed, I don't think that's going to be a problem. Okay, so does Blue Baby give us a portal to Delirium? This will determine whether or not this plan is going to work. He does give us a portal. So we don't have to wait for Mega Satan to die. We can kill him, and then we can teleport out during the death animation, and that counts as a kill. At least in my book, it does. So let's go fight Megastan. I'm not going to reroll Berserk, because I still think Berserk is going to be important against Delirium. That's good damage if we can push him past this phase without even doing anything. Without him doing anything. Trying to hit it with Nightlight. He's up on the patterns a little bit. Okay. The Mega Satan's down. Is this not going to work with Breath of Life? Let's see. Okay. We can use... it's going to immediately explode. Then we get Pandora's Box again. I don't even think it's going to do anything, will it? Whoa, okay. I'm not sure why it gave us that many items, but sure. Okay. So we get a one up here. And the pack, which is just great damage. We're going to have to use Berserk, I think. We can reroll into another spacebar item. Unless there's another one over here that I'm missing. We have a D1. D1, we can duplicate something on the ground. What? I don't know, but... Undefined. It's going to be hard to charge. It's going to be hard to charge. I think we retake Berserk. Circle Protection is going to be pretty good. Sorry, Spider Mod. Candy Heart. I think we're good on stats. Right now we're just looking for protection and for damage. Definitely want to take Parasitoid, Everything Jar. We just do that and clear one room. Okay, scissors, we can't do anything. So we're out of charges now. Bird's Eye is going to light the entire screen on fire, but it allows us to also block block tears. Let's see, trolls. I don't want to reroll. Blew up. Got the D7, though. Stopwatch. We're going to get a full charge out of this because it's a double wide. And get delirium. Okay, we have our Arawak. Let's go get our magician card and head on down to delirium. So, this is all contingent on us getting Diplopia or another death certificate or another R key. At this point, I'm committed. At this point, I'm committed. So, let's just do it. Obviously, this is extremely dangerous. With 3 HP, even... Oh... You remove two. If you're wondering how come we're not taking damage, by the way, it's because of Conehead. Occasionally we can proc it to where we don't take damage. Okay, we found that confessional booth super early. So as long as this isn't delirium, we should be able to remove all of our broken hearts. What we should do is we should hold on to magic skin in the meantime. Well, this is risky because if we run into delirium, then obviously us holding on to Berserk is not going to matter, but... For now, let's hold on to this. There we go. Just burning away the empty heart containers. It's still going. Hopefully, we get another clown poop from Bozo. Oh, Judas. Every red heart we get is another two taps on the confessional and another potential permanent HP container that we can get back. All right. Well, we're still going to... I mean, that was good, though. That was very good. We were able to get a whole lot of HP back. I think we got a grand total of 6... Now that we can have, so we effectively doubled our HP. No, we can get more than that. Strength card. Hey, look at that. That was a clutch confessional booth right there. Now, that being said, we still have magic skin, so I think we don't need... we don't need Berserk anymore. Now we know that we're going to be safe against Delirium. So we can use Magic Skin again on the next run to try to get another Arky or Diplopia. Having a reroll would definitely help out. But Delirium stands no chance. Even as buggy as he is, he stands no chance against this. Nothing in the game stands a chance against this. So after Delirium, all we're going to need is a mother and then old Beastie. That's it. And then that's a bona fide Omega run. One of them Vanchish Manchy Omega runs. And I'm actually kind of looking forward to it now. Like, I'm actually hoping that this works. Before, I was kind of like lukewarm on the idea. I was like, I really don't want to go for another 2 hours. The 2 hour run does not, doesn't sound great. But now I'm like, I'm fully awake and I'm like, yeah, let's do this. I was already kind of fully awake because of Lamb. And now we're all about that. Yeah. See you later, Isaac. Range upgrade. I am starving, though. Speaking for over an hour and a half, playing Isaac, that'd make anybody hungry, I think. Some Victor robes here. Barely even adding anything to our damage at this point. And, that's going to be a full clear of the void. Congrats, everyone. We did it. High five all around. The regular magician card. I think the combination of us with a magician, reverse magician, and the Arawak card is going to be too much for Delirium. I think this is going to be an absolute shellacking. We may not even need it. Look at that. Bird Eye completely stopping everything that Delirium had. Delirium down. We are key this. Here we are. Again, same seed. All right. Now it just comes down to finding a death certificate or another R key. And then it's just a walk in the park from there, because all we got to do now is just beat. We got to beat Mother. That's it. Well, no, that's not true. That's not true. We need to beat Mother and then also Beast, which is why we need the Arcane in the first place. But everything else is down, though. The D8. I really don't want the D8 to tank our stats and just swoop and dupe out of here. Okay, it didn't hurt us that much. It hurt, but not that much. So we go alt path here. And we want to stick with the angel deals because we want to try to undo the damage of magic skin. Yeah, I think we can do Devil's Crown because we have a Pound of Flesh. Oh man, just a random Capricorn just sitting out here. Yeah. So the play now is to just simply get... We need to get to a secret room. Well, there's Heartbreak. We need to get to a secret room and then just use... Hey, we did it. We did it. So you totally can You absolutely can re-roll into an R key and death certificate with M. And now that I know that, that brings M to a totally different level for me in terms of usefulness. And I definitely need to regrade M on the trinket tier list. Because that is pretty awesome. Gonna absolutely take duality here. Yeah, that moves, to me, that moves M from, I think I put it trash tier. To me, that moves M from trash tier to S tier. Easily, because you don't even have to have anything. You don't even have to have anything crazy in order for you to get an item like death certificate. Yeah, that's just phenomenal. We need to be careful. We don't break the mirror. I'm not going to worry about the other. There's no reason for us to fight another boss here, in my opinion. Let's just cruise on to victory here. So we're going to be able, with for all intents and purposes, at the time of saying this, we're going to be able to get another Omega run under our belt here. And I think that's pretty damn cool. Because I was not expecting something like this again anytime soon. I didn't even really like try to go for it, but here we are. I'm glad I did. Let's destroy these barrels first. Voodoo head, we don't need and don't want. Yeah, I mean, the golden red patch wouldn't be bad, but I'd rather just not lose any HP. The tough twins. More like dead twins. Mine's one, right? Yep, mine's one. Making sure we're not skipping anything. We'll skip a couple of the floor transitions, though. This is going to feel pretty darn good, assuming that we're able to do it all. Going to feel pretty good getting a second Omega run. If you don't know what an Omega run is, it means you've beaten every single boss on the same run. And no, I don't count victory laps. The fact that you're doing a victory lap and you're using R key, I don't consider that separate runs. You know what I mean? Like in one session, in one continuous Isaac run. That's what I have coined as the Omega run. That includes all optional bosses and boss rush. And all endgame bosses. And really, the only unavoidable endgame boss that you cannot get out of at all, unless if you pulled, unless you do what I did with, against Mega Satan, is Beast. But I think that Beast should be, in my opinion, the final boss. If you're attempting your own Omega runs. Now, of course, there was probably some way that we could have done this easier. There may have been a misplay or two where I could have made it a whole lot simpler, but you have to also remember that, like, I wasn't trying to do an Omega run here. So I didn't really leave with the mindset of, like, hey, we're going to get this done sort of a thing. Like, you know what I mean? Like, we're just simply, it sort of evolved into its own thing. That's my excuse and I'm sticking to it. Because inevitably someone in the comments is going to be like, you should have done this, you could have done this and that and this and that. And it's like, okay, well, I didn't. And I think it's okay. Shot speed is out of control. Empty vessel, yeah, we can take that. Oh, the Vizoid. Take the quarter, why not? Now, if we get red hearts on the ground, we should try to get rid of these rotten hearts. Just so, yeah, there you go. Lover's card will... Gotta do. The reason why I want to do that is just because obviously we're going to need the HP here to get into the mausoleum. I have absolutely no idea what's spawned and what's not in here. Get our angel deal here. Oh, I didn't even see a latchkey there. Seraphim. Yeah, we would get conjoined. I guess conjoined technically really doesn't matter because obviously we have tractor beam, but it's all right. Plot, buddy. I'm gonna try to speed things up here as I don't want to run the risk of this of OBS dying again. Not OBS, but the computer dying. Overheating the way it's been. So it would be that would be the ultimate slap in the face. If I did all this only for OBS to crash and then me not get footage because I record an MP4. I don't record an MKV, by the way, because there's a little bit of loss on the quality. The file size is also much, much larger, but it would also prevent instances of if the power goes out, you know, I don't lose everything, which is ideal. I mean, that's not ideal, but you know what I mean? Like not having to worry about that is ideal. We're going to be expeditious in this run here. Excuse me. Thank you. A range upgrade for that, and we're gonna head down to Corpse. It is kind of hilarious that we've gone through this entire 2-hour ordeal without getting any sort of mapping whatsoever. Quick and easy jaunt to the boss. Scourge is, yep. I'd say Scourge got purged. Looks like the exact same layout from the last one. But it's not, because the boss would have been over there. That's okay. There's definitely nothing more terrifying than an unreliable computer that could cost you hours and hours and hours of work. I'm trying not to make myself anxious over it, but I now feel the urgency. All right, let's get her done. All right, and with that, we need to only beat Beast. Final time you see the seed. Let's go close this one. Let's go close this puppy out. You're thick and thin, Blood Puppy. We made it. This one's gonna feel good. It'll feel good all over again. And all we gotta do is get to the depths two, and then we're gonna be placed right there. We already have the Polaroid or the negative. And obviously, Beast has absolutely no chance against us. Again, there's nothing in the game at this point that can hold. That can hold a candle to our damage. There's absolutely nothing the game can do. We're going to destroy any boss that we come across. This is definitely looking like one of our Isaac Madness runs here, which we will be doing more. We are definitely going to be doing more Isaac Madness runs in the future on YouTube. We had a lot of fun with that. Just so powerful right now that it's just, what is that? I can't even tell. I want to take Blood of the Martyr. Oh, it looked like Breath of Life for a second. I was like, how is that even there? I didn't take Jupiter because I don't think that anyone wants to hear Jupiter, including myself. I don't want to hear Jupiter at this point. Head on over to Beastie. Old Beastie. All All right, we are here in the mausoleum and ready to go for the second to last level. We're making our way to the second last level on this run. Now's not the time for some Victor navigation to be kicking in here. But we're gonna do a full clear anyway, because that's just how we roll here, y'all. That's how we do.
Spent it. It's gone. Just get over it.
Now, unfortunately, because we have stopwatch, we're not gonna be able to get the full effect of the music against Beast. But I think that'd be okay. I don't think we need it at this point. Excuse me? I thought we started over here. That's weird. The game is just, pretty sure the game is just giving up at this point. And honestly, I don't blame you, game. We absolutely raffle stomped this run. And honestly, we made some pretty big time plays. Thinking about M. And, you know, M is a dynamite trinket. What can I say? Admittedly, I'm first one to admit that I was wrong with the classification of M. Looking back on it, it almost seems asinine that I would even say that's trash tier. That's ridiculous. So definitely apologies to M fans out there. Now I see the potential. Now I see the good stuff. And if you enjoyed this run, make sure you click the like button. Leave a comment down below. Let me know what your favorite part of it was. Have you completed your own Omega run? Post screenshots below. And by below, I mean on our Civicta subreddit or in Discord. We have a screenshot section for all that kind of good stuff. I'd love to know if anyone out there has gotten their very own Omega run. We head on over to Dogma. Yeah, I'm just going to be skipping through all this stuff just because I want to get this recording done. It'd be very, very, very sad if we lost it now. Yeah, that's some good damage right there. Oh. Talk about bullying Dogma. All right, here we go, old Beastie. Let's see how fast Beast lives through this. Now it sounds like For Whom the Bell Tolls. Heyday, War. Down goes Death, and one more, there's a victory. Come on, Beast, you're holding up production here. See how long she lasts. There you go. Phase two is in effect. Moving backwards? Okay. All right, there it is, everyone. The Omega Run number two has been completed. Thank you all very much. That feels good, man. That feels good. If you enjoyed this video, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. I don't know how you could not enjoy that one, but if you didn't for some reason, then go ahead and leave a dislike. The likes do help out. The likes actually count a lot more than dislikes now. They're no longer equal. So I would appreciate it. Definitely leave a comment down below. Let me know about your own Omega runs. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Steven Sneed, Exodus, Bake Nico, Dalton Bruce, Maracy, and C9 Melvin. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, then check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.